Yo, what is going on, guys? It is Sam Orr Burns, and welcome back to week two of the South Alabama Dynasty. We're just checking out the top 25 polls here. You see we have a new number one and two, Ohio State and Georgia, as Alabama loses 38-7 in the Chick-fil-A kickoff game against Virginia Tech and drops all the way to number 11. And Clemson would also lose to the Georgia Bulldogs. But other than that, not too much change. You see Virginia Tech jumping into the top 25 after a victory against Alabama, and Arizona State and Mississippi State also jump into the top 25 after some losses by some other teams in front of them. Oklahoma State, Oregon State, and Northern Illinois all drop out, as you see right there. So some surprising games. I did not expect Alabama to lose this early. And you'll see our Heisman watch is the same it was at the start of the year. Manziel, McCarron, Braxton Miller, Teddy Bridgewater, and Marcus Mariota. So we're checking out the Sun Belt Conference Players of the Week for Week 1. You see Boston's quarterback Ben McLean, his backup quarterback, getting Offensive Player of the Week for the Sun Belt. And my linebacker, Clifton Cruz, with three tackles, two sacks against FCS in that eight-point win. He's getting Defensive Player of the Week, so great job right there by him. It's great to see getting some accolades here early, although it might have been against FCS. So if you did not hear, Boston won his Week 1 game 42-21 against FCS. So we both stand at 1-0 here after Week 1. Now we're looking at some recruiting. I didn't change all that much. Just going to go ahead and show you what I have right now. I have only about 150 points to spend. So I went ahead and offered a scholarship to Paul Lee. It looks like we're pretty much out of the Paul Lee race anyway, but I did it just because you know, maybe there's a chance we can get back in. I highly doubt that we even have a chance at signing him. You know, he's a really good quarterback. He's number 9 in the nation. So the odds of us signing him are very low, but other than that, we got 100 points left to spend. I think I had a scholarship offered to pretty much everyone except Matt Harris up there. I don't know why I didn't offer it to him. But I'm going to go ahead and offer the scholarship to Jabari Crowder. He's a fullback at Montgomery, Ohio. And then I do end up offering the scholarship to Matt Harris, I believe. Or no, I scout Matt Harris. Okay. But yeah, so we're just looking at the pregame screen right there. You see our statistics compared to Tulane, who we're playing this week. So, you know, we have decent stats. You know, we're a middle-of-the-road team right now in terms of stats. But anyways, guys, you know, let's get this game started. They got a 92 overall kicker. But anyways, let's get it started.
Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Perhaps you've heard New Orleans called the Big Easy. Nothing will come easily today in the Louisiana Superdome, the site of so many championship games. A huge game today. Both teams out on the floor of the Superdome, everybody getting loose. A highly anticipated battle as we close in on kickoff. That does it for us here on the NCAA College Football pregame show. Enjoy the game. We'll see you at the half.
Alright, let's get this game started. We're playing in New Orleans against the Tulane Green Wave, and Tulane is actually a pretty good team. For those of you that don't know, their quarterback is none other than Joe Montana's son, Nick Montana, and he's very good. And Nick Montana here on 3rd and 10! Oh, he had a guy deep. He throws his third incomplete pass on that drive as Tulane goes 3 and out. And then you see our quarterback, Ross Matheny, had a great game against FCS. He did throw a pick or two, but overall he played very well. So Matheny, back to pass, and he is sacked for a loss of 10 yards. Still playing very well so far. There you see his season passing stats again. But, you know, he is our best player, so he's got to perform on a high level. So Matheny under center. Play action pass to Jay Jones. Nowhere really to go, but oh, beautiful pass by Matheny. Going to find Wes Saxton there on the left side for a first down. Now Matheny back to pass again on the left side on a little curl route. Going to find Jeremy Jones this time for a first down. 13-yard reception. That's Jones' first catch of the game. So the Jaguars on a drive, handing it off to Jones on the draw play. Only a little 2-yard gain, but still going to get us that much closer to the end zone. That's Jones' first rush. And here, Matheny back to pass on a screen play. Finding Jones on the right side. Oh, runs over that guy. 10-yard reception. That's going to be a first down for the Jaguars. So looks like South Alabama looking to strike first here. Ross Matheny looking good on this first drive. Third down and goal now. Matheny back to pass. Nowhere to go. And he finds Bryant Lavender. 2-yard touchdown right there. Ross Matheny goes 4-5 on that drive. And here's a studio update.
Game ranked number 18 in the country. Back and forth these two teams go. Neither one giving an inch. We could be headed to a photo finish. And for McDonald, he's caught a touchdown pass. The Wildcats are out front 17-14.
So the K-State Wildcats playing their first game without Colin Klein in a while, and it looks like they're struggling, only up 3 on the lowly UL Lafayette Raging Cajuns. You know, we'll see what happens in that game, but Orleans Darkwa, I think it's funny that Orleans is playing in New Orleans, but he's going to run right there, not get much, but on 3rd down and 8, Nick Montana going to find Banks on the left side. He breaks a tackle down to the 40-yard line, a 29-yard reception by Kedrick Banks. What a play right there. Great effort by Banks right there. So Montana under center, handoff, no, play action to Darkwa right side. He's gonna find Marfisi, I guess as I say, but Montana here in the shotgun, second down and goal, gonna run an option, pitches it to Darkwa, and that is easy right there. Is Tulane gonna tie this game up 7-7 here in the first quarter, about a minute and a half remaining in that first quarter, and you'll see the replay right here. I thought it was going to be the replay, but it ended up not being the replay. So, and then here's the replay. Look at me just contradicting myself back and forth. But great play right there by Tulane to tie the game 7-7. Now Ross Matheny back to pass. He's got it, man. It's Bryant Lavender, the man that caught the touchdown pass earlier. He's going to get 24 more yards added to his season total. He's got 2 catches for 26 yards on the day. Now 1st down and 10. Matheny on the screen pass going to find Jones, who's got some room. Good cut, and he's going to get 11 yards on the reception for a first down, and the Jaguars driving again, looking to go back up by 7 here as the first quarter winds down. Now 1st and 10, about 50 seconds to go. Matheny, play action pass. Beautiful pass to Wes Sexton, and he gets in the end zone. Touchdown, Jaguars. And the South Alabama Jaguars go up 14-7 here in the first quarter as it's starting to wide down. Only about 45 seconds left. And you'll see the replay right here. Look at that beautiful rainbow pass showing off that total control passing and those new passing lobs or whatever you want to call them, you know, trajectories. But here's another studio update from Reese Davis.
The Hurricanes and Gators in the battle for the Seminole War Canoe. And for Florida, we might have an upset percolating in this one. Miami has the edge, 10-7.
Okay, so according to Reese Davis, we have an upset percolating. I'm going to start using that word. But Miami looking to pull off that upset on Florida. Arch rival, Gators, Hurricanes. You know, we'll see how that ends up going. But great first quarter so far. 14-7, Jaguars on top. Looking to improve to 2-0 on the season, which would be awesome. And someone corrected me. This isn't South Alabama's first year as an FCS program. Or FBS program. It's actually their second, but they weren't in NCAA 13, which is why I assumed they were a first-year FBS program. But that's my bad. I apologize for that. But you'll see Kelly there on the left side, Rob Kelly on the 14-yard run, showing his strength breaking that tackle. First and goal now for Tulane. Montana handing off to Kelly into the end zone. 3-yard run for Rob Kelly as he's going to tie this game 14-14. The Green Wave look good so far on offense. Both teams are. Now Matheny back to pass. Another beautiful pass to Wes Sexton. He has been the best receiver for this Jaguar offense this entire season. Now Matheny gonna hand off to Jones. What a good cut right there. Jones, he can still go. Pushed out at the 35-yard line. 19-yard gain right there. Oh, my bad. It's the 25-yard line. But a great run right there by Jay Jones as he's going to get the huge first down on that 19-yard run. Now we're going to hand off to Houston, the backup. And he's going to get a good run, 9 yards right there by Kendall Houston. So a 3rd and 1 now turns into a 3rd and 10 later in the drive. Matheny back to pass over the middle. Finds Bryant Lavender. Can't quite get in. Almost gets his second touchdown catch of the day. He's got 3 catches for 40 yards so far. Matheny on the read option. Can he get in? Yes, he can. Touchdown, Jaguars. as South Alabama going to take over 21-14. Now, 3 minutes to go, Nick Montana back to pass, going to find Rush on the left side, and he gets a little more yards than I wanted him to. Obviously, I'd rather have him get no yards, but I felt like I could have pushed him out earlier. But now, fourth down and one. We held him to a fourth down. Nick Montana, can they get it? Hand off to Kelly. Stepped in the backfield. South Alabama gets the ball back with a minute 56 to go in the first half and with a chance to take a 14-point lead going into halftime. Now, Matheny on the right side, nowhere to go. Gets away from everyone, and he somehow gets the first down on a 12-yard scramble. That seemed like actually luck almost. I remember when I played this, that was just, I felt so lucky to be able to get that first down. So, you know, we're trying to get a drive going here, trying to take the, you know, bigger lead heading in halftime. Matheny, back to pass, got a man on the left side. It's Lavender again. He's having a huge game. 175 passing yards for Ross Matheny so far. Now Matheny, back to pass, nowhere to go, scrambling on the right side. Can he get anywhere? No. Fumble! And it's pushed out of bounds right there by Jeremy Jones as South Alabama is going to retain possession. Close call for the Jaguars, but Matheny back to pass, screenplay. Nowhere to go. He's hit as he throws, and it's picked. 20, 30. There's no one in front of him. He's going all the way. And Tulane, just like that, ties this game up at 21 off a huge interception for a touchdown. I don't even know how long that was. 90 yards? That was ridiculous. A terrible pass right there. Right to Jordan Batiste as he's going to intercept that and go to the house. And also, more bad news. Ross Matheny out for the remainder of the game, so we got to bring in our backup, Bridge, with the 31-yard pass to Wes Saxton. So we still have a chance to take a lead heading into halftime, which is definitely something I want to do. You know, it would be awesome. Now, Bridge, back to pass again. Looking over the middle. Incomplete. No! Intercepted by Davis! That was the most ridiculous interception I've ever seen in a football video game. Zach Davis, you'll see the replay right here. As it should have hit the ground, but somehow didn't as Davis dives to save it. So Nick Montana and the Tulane offense gets one more chance. Montana to Shackelford! What a name. Look at this name. Justin Shackelford. But second and 10 now, 23 seconds to go. Tulane only one timeout. Going to hand off to Kelly with a big run. Can he get in? No. Harris stops him short of the goal line. But Rob Kelly with a 13-yard run to make it first and goal. But we ended up stopping him enough to the point where they had to kick a field goal. So we got a 24-21 halftime game. And I will see you guys after the halftime show.
The Green Wave in front, 24-21.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Offensive coordinators get a lot of attention in college football these days. Understandably so, a lot of innovation going on in the sport.
Yep.
I don't know if this is innovation as much as just execution and explosive playmaking.
Yeah, and there's always a rhythm and a flow to offensive play calling. And you can see them when they start to get into it and everything just goes perfect. And right now, that's the rhythm and flow. I mean, right now, everything that they're dialing up seems to be working. And that's a special skill. It's not everybody can do it. Sometimes you get too creative and shoot yourself in the foot. But right now, passing it will, running it will, really picking good spots for both of those plays. For whether it's a run or a pass, they're picking their spots, and it's working really well.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. It's going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk, ready with a call.
All right, so, you know, we are heading into the second half, only down three, but with a backup quarterback who hasn't seen any playing time up until this point. And you see him throw the incomplete pass right there on third down, so we end up having to give the ball back to Nick Montana and this dangerous two-lane offense. But Montana, as he's dropping back to pass, is sacked right there by Montavious Williams. What a name. And now Montana on the screen to Rob Kelly, pushed out of bounds right there by Jones. Great defense to force a fourth down as South Alabama are going to be getting the ball back here with another chance to take the lead. Bridge back to pass, dump off pass to Jones, and a huge gain right there. 16 yards for Jay Jones on the little dump off pass. Now third and eight, Bridge back to pass on the left side. He's got Jeremy Jones this time. First Jay Jones, now Jeremy Jones, first down on another 16-yard reception. Jeremy Jones with his second catch of the game on this little curl route. You'll see it right there. Perfect timing between the quarterback and receiver as Jeremy Jones is going to get a good enough gain there for a first down. So great play, but he is down on the play. He will return soon, but he is down for now. So Bridge back to pass over the middle. Going to find Wes Saxton, who absolutely trucks that guy. He goes down immediately, but he flat-backed the guy trying to tackle him. Bridge back to pass over the middle. Going to find Jeremy Jones again. 13-yard gain. And it looks like South Alabama knocking on the door. The Jaguars with another chance to take the lead. Jones, he is in. Touchdown. South Alabama takes the lead. They lead it 28-24 now. And here's a studio update.
Gators in the battle for the Seminole War Canoe. And for Miami, as time runs out, clock on zero, they score. The Hurricanes storm to the win. 20-17.
Wow, that was a nice pun. I guess the Hurricanes stormed the win. Okay, but you'll see Miami, the Hurricanes, they pull off the upset on the Gators. Great job by them to knock off the number 8 ranked team. We got more to worry about, including Nick Montana and Ryan Grant. No, that's not the Ryan Grant from the Packers, but 59 yards as Nick Montana is up to 324 yards passing, giving his Tulane Green Wave a 31-28 lead right now. And then Bridge, not much experience. He didn't know that he shouldn't have made that throw right there. I knew as soon as I made it that I shouldn't have made the throw, but it doesn't look like Bridge knows what he's quite doing out there. He's an inexperienced quarterback. So heading into the fourth quarter, we only trail by 3, but Nick Montana and Tulane knocking on the door. Montana on the right side, going to find Xavier Rush for a 16-yard gain. That's going to be a first down. And now Tulane knocking on the door. Third and inches. Can we stop him? No contest right there. Rob Kelly walks into the end zone as Tulane goes up by 10 with only about 6 minutes to go. Is this game pretty much in the bag for Tulane? Bridge over the middle, going to find Corey Bastida. We haven't heard his name much at all this game. How about none, as he gets his first catch of the day. First time I've actually even had to mention his name. Bridge back to pass, looking over the middle on another slant play. This time going to find Glover, who's going to get a 17-yard gain right there. TJ Glover on the catch. Great play. Bridge looking on the right side. He's got a man. It's Wes Saxton. Who else but Wes Saxton? 34 yards. I don't think it was 34 yards. I didn't quite see. But, you know, here's a game track on Nick Montana, just showing how he's absolutely tearing us apart. You know, I have trouble stopping the pass with this South Alabama defense, so you know, I'm doing my best I can. We're only down 3, but we need to stop. As you see, Nick Montana's only thrown 6 incomplete passes, 3 of those coming on the first drive. Now 2:50 to go. Ryan Grant just had a huge touchdown. Why not add some more yards onto that? As you see, the Jaguar mascot not very happy about that. 2:22 remaining. Nick Montana back to pass. Looking on the left side, going to find Mafisu. And he's going to get absolutely decked, Matt Mafisi. Matt Mafisi. But a minute 47 now, second down and 10. Hand off to Rob Kelly. He's got space. 20, 10, 5. Tackled at the 5-yard line. And we do hold him to a field goal, so the Jaguars have a chance. We got one last drive to win this game and improve our record to 2-0. We'll see if we can do it. Now second down and 10. Bridge back to pass. He's got a guy. No, he doesn't got a guy anymore. Intercepted by Robertson. And that is going to do it. The fourth turnover of the game for South Alabama. Third by Bridge. And Bridge pretty much lost the game for us. You know, I'm not going to blame him, but there's a reason he's not our starting quarterback. It would have been nice to have Ross Matheny in there to finish this game out. He was playing so well in the first quarter. But obviously, it's a really disappointing loss. We were on the road. But, it was awesome to be able to compete with Tulane. They're a better team than us, but it would have been awesome to win this game on the road. However, we're going to come away with a 41-35 loss. The disappointment's definitely there, but I guess, you know, we showed some potential. I think if we would have had our starting quarterback the entire game, this could have been a different ball game. Who knows? It's the past now. South Alabama falling to 1-1 on the season. Haven't played our conference opener yet, but we do fall to 1-1. We still got that first win of the season last week, so you know, it's hopefully we end up with more wins than South Alabama had last year, a total of 2. But anyways, guys, I hope you did enjoy. I know it was a long video, and if you stuck around for the entire thing, I absolutely appreciate it. And if you did enjoy, it would be awesome if you would leave a like. And yeah, so South Alabama ends up losing this game. You'll see some games around the country, nothing too surprising, except for Nevada losing to FCS West, who we beat last week. But anyways, guys, I want to thank you guys for watching. I hope you did enjoy, and I will see you guys next time.